I ran into a few H.
Okay,
H and H and B. Now B came to my stream before. Okay. B has been in my stream before. And then she left and then she came back. When she returned back, she was like, "Hey, if you don't remember me, I'm the person I came to your stream. I didn't have no level, but I got a level now." And she was like, "You didn't want to talk to me when I didn't have a level." That's what she said to me. I quickly let her know, it's not that I didn't want to talk to you when you didn't have a level, it's that I didn't notice you when you didn't have a level. I said, I didn't notice you, number one. I said, and the reason why is because there's so many people. So I had to explain to her that when you have a lot of people that's in your room, you won't stand out unless you're sending a gift sometimes. Okay, and it's designed, the app is designed that way. You know, when you send a gift, you turn yellow. What yellow represents a highlighted color, right? So that's why it's easier to see those people that are gifted, you know. So I did explain that to her, but at the same time, when she was in the room, H was in the room. Okay. Now, I'm not going front. I was like kind of like shooting my shot at H, and H was like, "Hey, what's going on here? I'm brand new here." And I said, "You know what's going on here? You gotta click that gift box and you gotta send those gifts. Make sure I went." I said it as a joke to her, but she definitely clicked that gift box and started sending gifts.
Okay, you know, let me pause you right here. So if y'all are just coming into the live, this is Dating Unfiltered. We are in story number two with Role Model Fresh here. We kind of gone through and gave everybody kind of a little explanation of app culture, how Role found the app and got into the live feature. So I need to make sure, especially those of you that are new here, you are putting yourself in a live feature mode, right? So the interaction is, you know, one streamer just like me here and speaking and engaging with comments and people that are interacting. So Role is on her live stream and two women are in there, B and H. B is somebody who had visited Role's stream before. And then had kind of disappeared for a little bit and has come back and just said, "Hey, you know, I got a little level. I've been spending some time on here. Do you notice me now?" And H had come in around the same time and just said, "Hey, how does this work?" So Role was shooting her shot at H a bit, you know, kind of.
I was, you know, flirting with H and, you know, I thought H was killing it. H started like gifting me crazy, helping me win battles and stuff like that. And it wasn't really about that, but I would say this, the very next day, when I came on stream, I'll be quite honest with you. It's the app. It's like no one knows. A lot of the big people don't never know who you are until you have a big gifter that comes to your room. Now, here's what happened. These two women was in there flirting with me. They was flirting with me so much that while they was flirting, I was flirting back. And one of them said, "Hey, listen, we could be in a poly. So when she said a poly, I said, "You into that?" And she's like, "Yeah." I said, "I ain't never do it, but let's do it." But what? I said it as a joke. I said, "Let's do it. This is a poly. We're all in a poly." I said that as a joke, right? That same day, when I said we all in a poly, guess what? She dropped a milli, and that was my first time ever getting a milli dropped on me in one stream. All right? She dropped a milli, and then B dropped the milli and H turned around and dropped the milli too.
Oh, so that was like, well, that was like your dowry. That was like your dowry. Like y'all were like,
yeah.
That's funny. Okay.
So I went from having like 8.5 milli, guys. I was brand new on the app pretty much. I went from having about 8.5 milli to 11 mil, like close to 12 mil with that one sitting. And that's when I noticed a lot of top badges and boss badges start coming into my room, but of course they could see my name high on the leaderboard. Okay. That's when I noticed how many people was really fake on the app, but we're not going to talk about that. What I'm saying, because you know they start coming in and wanting to send me verses and stuff like that, but I didn't let that, you know, I don't let stuff like that bother me. But go on, bro. So guys, just to let you know, whenever you're having a lit stream and you see that happening, ask yourself why. That's exactly why. Okay. So because they seen that, they came in the room, of course, starting to flirt with a lot of my gifters and stuff like that. I don't pay no mind to that. You know, what's meant for me will always be for me. And 2 days later, I want to say 2 days later, B caught me and B had an attitude with me.
Okay, so hold on. B and H go ham, drop this million. Y'all are in a poly. So I'm assuming, so do you just, is this on app, or you said you was handing the phone number out before, but at this point, are you guys all talking on the phone now? Like, is this moving?
Yeah. Like, we'll talk on the phone, but we weren't talking together.
Gotcha.
You know, like, I talked to her, but it wasn't like that deep. You know what I'm saying? It was like, I gave her my number, like, to tell her about the app and stuff like that. And then H, the same thing, but it was more of a, more flirty. You know what I'm saying? Getting to know her, more flirty. With B, I could sense B has an attitude. So I'm like, hey, what's up, B? Like, what's going on with you? And she's like, well, I put the M in my name, and we're supposed to be a family, and you ain't acting like a family. And I'm like, wait, what does that mean? What do you mean I'm not acting like a family? So she's like, I'm like, she keep using the family word. And I'm like, well, what's your definition of family, love? Like, because I think I'm doing everything I'm supposed to do by my family, you know? Like, you just got here. You don't know what, how deep this family is. So what's up, 40? I see you guys. We in the middle of a show, so give me a second. All right, so when she said that, I'm like, what do you mean by family? So she said, you know what I mean? Yesterday, the poly, you, me, and H.
Oh, and she, I said, for real. She was serious.
I said, you serious? And she was like, yeah. I said, wait, so this is a thing? And she's like, yeah. I said, what? I didn't know that. I was joking. I said, so you for real? Like, you want a poly between a... And I was like, well, I can't be in an official relationship with you. I said, I can't do that. Because if I haven't met you, I can't be in a relationship with you.
Okay, hold on, pause. In the comments, online dating is a thing. Would you get into a committed relationship with somebody that you hadn't met yet? Like, could you, yes, okay, roll. Several people in here say yes, they could do it if they hadn't met yet. What was your qualm about not meeting yet?
My thing was, I just don't do that because here's my thing, like, you might look beautiful on camera, but I don't know how you smell. What if I meet you and you smell like dogs? You know what I'm saying? I don't know if your breath stink. I don't know if you use deodorant. I don't know if you keep your crib clean. I don't do that.
Or you could be the killer.
I just gotta see you. I gotta be able to feel you, hold you, smell you. You understand what I'm saying? I can't be in no relationship imagining how you smell. No, I want to know how you smell.
Fair.
I'm not gonna use my imagination.
Okay.
If we're dating. Okay. So you know, so I pretty much told them, I was like, you know, until we meet, we're not we can talk, we can do this or whatever. I'm fine with that.
Is
you know
cool with it? Or this was just the conversation with you?
This is just me and B right now. Okay. This is just me and B. This is our first initial. This is when I finally realized, oh, this is it. This is a thing. You know what I'm saying? So then I immediately got off the phone with B. Got on the phone with H, like, you are not gonna believe that. Remember when I told you she was tripping? And she's like, yeah. And I said, you know what she thinks? And she's like, what? I said, she thinks we in a poly. Like, this is for real. And she was like, oh, I thought she was joking. And I was like, nah, she was serious. So she was like, she started laughing. I was like, is that something you with? She was like, yeah, I don't care.
Wait. So you've now just jokingly all agreed.
Yeah, wind up in a poly.
Okay.
So now here's what I did. I put us all three. I called all three of us because she's calling in now while I'm on the phone with her. Now here's the biggest problem, and here's why I will never do a poly again. Because when you're in a poly, it demands a lot of attention. Especially if you're not living in a house with the both of them, it's a lot of work, a lot of attention that you have to give them. So for an example, I could finish doing a 5-6 hour stream, and then guess what? B is calling me, H is calling me, both of them want private time. I can't give you private time, okay? We gonna both have this conversation on the phone together.
Right?
And sometimes even when I do that, guess what winds up happening? When I'm on the phone with both of them,
messaging,
hang up and I say it's time for me to go to bed, they're still both calling me because they want that private time. And I'm like, when am I gonna get time to myself? You understand? So that was the number one thing that made it really hard to do, okay? And because they were so open with the relationship, it allowed me to start, like, and I was new to it. So I used this platform as a way for me to cope through things, you know what I'm saying, and discuss like my life situations. So I met Elle. Elle was cool. That was someone I used to always flirt with and stuff, and she used to flirt with me and stuff like that too. But me and her was just really good friends, you know what I'm saying? We always kept it as friends, but and then I noticed she started catching feelings. Okay, now I'm not going front. I started to find her, you know, more and more attractive and stuff like that. Now, but like I said, was cool.
Question.
Uh-huh.
Now, you described the poly situation being stressful, and Elle was a good friend.
Elle was a good friend.
Would you confide in Elle about your frustrations with your poly situation?
I sure did.
Okay, comments. Okay, let's put this in context, right? Maybe not in a poly, but if you're in a relationship or and you start confiding in a friend about your frustration, and now said friend, I'm assuming you said express that she now has feelings.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right.
It's not feelings. I see you. All right. So here's what happened. Hey guys, if you're just joining us, we're in the middle of a show, and I am telling my entanglement story, guys. So hop on over to Jilly's room so you can catch the rest of it. Oh, just stay right here. All right, so now she Elle, you know, I start confiding in her and stuff like that. And I would let them know. I would tell them. I'd be like, oh, I spoke to Elle, you know. And then they started to raise the question, like, well, do you like Elle? And I said, no, Elle's just cool. We flirt, but we just cool. And besides, and I always made it clear that I am not in a relationship. Okay, I always made it clear. We're not in a relationship. So technically, I'm free to do what I want. I don't need to hide anything. But one of the things they kept asking me was, am I talking to Elle? Oh, and I'm like, no, I'm not talking to Elle. So one of them does the reverse psychology bullcrap. It's like, you know, it's okay if you do because she's beautiful, you know, just add to the group. And I said, word? Add to the group?
Which like, one? Oh, hold on. In the comments, which person do you think was doing this? In the comments, you think it was B or H? B or H, y'all think, was B as in boy, or H was the one saying it was cool? I see a lot of H's.
I see a lot of H's too, but it was B.
But I think I was going to go.
It was B.
B.
It was B. She pulled the okie doke and told me it was okay.
Okay.
And stuff. H, you know, H didn't even really mind and stuff like that. She didn't really care. Like, she would have those moments where she just don't care. Okay. So Elle, I'm like talking to Elle, and I was like, oh, you know what they asked me? Blah, 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 blah. And then she said, like, if I was to do that, I would just want you to myself. I ain't going to be none of that. I'm selfish. So I said, you know, and in all reality, I am too. Like, I wouldn't want to share the person I'm with. You know what I'm saying? But I'm like, I'm trying this out, and I'm seeing like where it's going to go and stuff like that. And all of them keep talking about days they want to meet up, but nobody's doing no moves. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So that was another thing that kept happening. So in the meantime,
you're streaming, you're juggling your stream life. And this is, and we're talking, this is right, like 2020 still, right? Early 2020. So it's this like peak busy, yeah. Like it's moving, right? So mm-hmm. Maximum stream time, juggling attentions of B and H, trying to make them in your stream as well. So you're trying to stream and then still manage their whatever expectations they have, and then the attention off the app, your friendship with L. So you're juggling all of this simultaneously.
Yes.
Okay. This is stressful.
Yeah.
This is stressful.
So now I'm gonna make a long story short, guys. Yeah. So now L winds up catching feelings for me. And when L started catching feelings, she expressed herself to me. I started to catch feelings too. So she already told me her feelings she had for me. I never actually admitted that I had feelings for her, like, hey, I'm starting to like you too, or whatever. And on that same day when I did, okay, the same day when I did admit those that I had feelings for her and stuff, I did not tell L, I did not tell H and B, okay? I didn't tell them that, you know? So, but I seen her, L was on her stream, and she had M come in there. M was brand new to the app, start dropping heavy on her. Okay, so M is a stud. Okay, M is a stud, and she start like dropping crazy on L. And I noticed, you know, you always notice a person's pattern. We would always get on stream the same time. We'll get off stream the same time. And I noticed lately she hasn't been getting on the same time. And I also noticed that when she does get on, that person automatically goes to her room as if, you know, you just got off the phone with her. So, you know, you can feel it. It's that with that intuition and stuff. And I asked her, I was like, yo, blah, blah, blah. Are you talking to M? Like, what is going on? Because we agreed that we wouldn't give our number out.
Okay, but you're also still managing the B.
I'm also still managing H and B. You know what I'm saying? Okay. So we had an agreement to not give our number out because we admitted how we felt. But I was gonna tell H and H and B, you know, that whatever the case is, because they act like they didn't care anyway. Okay. So now I found so later on in my stream, M winds up showing up to my stream. Okay. Brand new to the app, she was like, yo, you mad cool. I know I put it on your top, but here. And she sent me about 50K. Okay. And I was real excited about the 50K. And she was like, yo, you know, I'm interested in someone. And it was a psychic lady in my room. And she could kind of feel like the story was about to have a twist in it.
Okay, so hold on. Just so y'all know, there's all types of people on this app. So there are people on the app that stream and read tarot cards and have readings and do that on the app. So if you're brand new here, when I tell you, you can find anything on this app, any type of entertainment, any type of it. So there, when she says there's a psychic, there are people on here who are mediums or who do that on the app. So in this stream, one of them was in your box. I think someone that you were familiar with that had given you a reading and stuff before. So she wasn't like just saying that in a weird way, a genuine person who does that for a living. So mm-hmm. was there.
Okay, so she was like, I can sense. She was like, keep talking. There's something going up. You guys are in like, and she kind of said like in an entanglement, but we're like, what are you talking about? I'm like, what are you talking about? You just talking crap. So, and then the girl starts telling me she really likes this girl. And I said, who you really like? Let me know because I'm going to hook you up with them. You know what I'm saying? Wait. And then she turns around.
You was ready to hook her up with, let me know. I'm going to hook you up.
And then she tells me it was L. But when she said it was L, I said, oh, shit. L done lied to me and everything. L told me she didn't give a number out. And stuff like that. Come to find out, L definitely gave her number out. When I confronted L about it, L hit me with this. L said, I didn't give her my number. I gave her a text-free number. But what's the difference?
Hold on. How many of y'all got your text-free number or your save a text, the different number that you give out because it's not your real number? Be honest. Be honest if you have one. No. Mm-hmm. You know, it's safe to have it, but also...
Look at that. So I got three. I was tight. I ain't go front. She told me that, and I said, listen, and I explained to M. I said, M, you know, from stud to stud, we're not together. I said, we're not together, but we are talking. And one of the things we said was this. And I said, I'll be honest with you. I got my own little thing going on with my Polly, and that's a bit too much for me. I said, if you like her, that's fine. The part I'm mad at is the fact that she lied to me. Okay, don't lie to me, because then I'm done with you after you lie. So, okay. And that's what wound up happening. I went to her and I said, oh, so you're not talking up? And she was like, well, it's a text-free number. Well, she told me y'all was on the phone. Y'all been speaking ever since then, and now y'all talking. She told me y'all talking, you know? So she tried to lie, and I said, you know what? I'm good off you. I don't want to talk to you again. Okay. She got in her feelings. She got really upset. She went and called WhatsApp. WhatsApp B and H.
Okay. Pause.
Yes.
Hold on. Right here. We have to pause right here. Cajun and D'Angelo, are you in here right now? If you guys are still here, please hit the box already. If y'all are just joining us, this is Dating Unfiltered, a special event here on POF just for tonight with me is Jilly Baby. We are getting role models, a Dating Unfiltered story here, and this all is taking place on stream. Role model, fresh to streaming, meets B and H. Okay, she's coming. We got her. She's coming. We got her coming. She's coming, Queen. We got you coming. D'Angelo, are you here?
I like to see her facial expressions when I tell the story.
Nobody here knows yet. So she's coming.
Okay.
So we have B and H. Okay, B and H have hit the streams and have hit it hard, gifting like crazy. B has said, "Well, we can be in a poly. We can be together." Rose says, "Yeah, sure, why not?" Took it as a joke, but B was serious. Okay, B was serious. Rose calls serious. H and says, "She was serious. Like, are you with this?" H says, "Sure, why not? I thought it was a joke, but let's do it." So they are in this poly situationship, okay, together. Role is managing this, and she's expressed her struggles with this, right? It is tough because it's asking for a lot of time, and when they want individual time, then they want together time. But she says, "Listen, this is not really official until we actually meet, because I can't date anybody that I haven't met, but we can make this do what it do," okay? So they're still in her stream, managing off on the side and managing her poly situation. She also has L, who's another streamer. They've become really good friends, and she starts confiding in her a little more. They get a little closer, you know, talking about this poly situation that she has. And L is very, you know, straightforward. Like, if it was me, you know, you wouldn't have to worry. But all of this starts to happen, and she starts to get closer and admits, you know, I kind of have feelings too. But the poly's here. L didn't really mind it. So she decides, you know what, we're talking, but let's make an agreement. We don't give our phone numbers out. Fine. So they continue on the app. They're versing one day. In comes M. M is on L's side, and M starts just dropping heavy on L. Makes it, you know, romantics a note. And you know, we all have patterns, right? Patterns with dating. And when you're talking to somebody, Rose started noticing that, you know, every time L gets on, M is there. She starts getting on. Her pattern's a little different. Something just seems off with it.
Right.
Something ain't right, okay?
It's in the dark always come to light, especially stop playing.
So she notices that, but just kind of files that away. So M one day joins Roll Stream just randomly. And she joins, says, "Hey, you know, I didn't mean to like do that to you so much on the app, but you know, here's a little something. And you know, I think you're really cool." It happened to be a time where there was someone in Rose box that was like was a psychic, was medium and talking about, you know, energies and stuff, and somehow feels the energy between what is happening in the stream and pretty much references Rose and Emma and says, "Hey, you guys are kind of like tied together somehow. I think there's something going on here." And Rose's like, "What?" And they start talking about this, and they come to the conclusion and find out that they are both talking to L. And she says, "But wait a minute, how?" And realizes that L did give her phone number out to M. So she confronts L. L says, "What? I didn't even give her my number. I gave her my text-free number." Roll says, "That's not what we agreed to. I'm not even upset about this. I have my poly anyway. I'm upset that you lied, to me, okay?" She says, "But I'm over it. I'm done. I'm moving on." L does not like this. So now
L is upset. L is like, "Oh, you just gonna stop talking to me?" And I'm like, yeah, that's the type of person I am. If you lie to me and I can't trust you and stuff, and that wasn't the first time she did something that made me not trust her. So I was like, yeah, I'm done. Okay. And I knew for a fact she wasn't done, because she made it clear that she was going to wreak havoc. You know, sometimes women are vindictive when they don't get what they want. Okay, they get caught, but they want to be vindictive as if you did something wrong. So what she then turned around and did was she got on a three-way call. Okay, she got on the phone with B and H. All right, now I'm receiving a phone call on a WhatsApp. And next thing you know, I see all three of them.
Wait.
And I'm like, oh, shoot.
Wait. She finds a way to get on a WhatsApp call with B and H.
Yeah, she called them.
She calls all three of them. And then you get a video call from who? Whose number rings up?
It showed all of them.
It showed
B's name and H names. And then, when I always see that call come through.
Right.
So I just answered it right away. I didn't pay attention. I was at work.
So then you look down and you see across your phone three yes. faces where there should be two. When there should be two. Okay.
Exactly.
Okay. Okay.
So now I'm like, so now they're like, you can tell they already had the conversation and they wanted to ask me, am I talking to L? So when they asked me, I told them no. And then they asked me, did I like L? I said, yeah, I liked her. But I said, guys, honestly, the reason why she's doing this is because blah, blah, blah. And I explained to them a little bit of what happened. You understand what I'm saying? And then when we got off the phone, off the three-way call, I then spoke to H was like, I'm fine. H was like, she was good. You know what I'm saying? More miserable. Come over to Jilly's room. We over. I'm telling my entanglement story. Yeah, because I'm over here. Sorry. So now she's like, you know, B is the one having the hard time. And I said, hold up, B. Like, how are you upset when you the one that told me you would be fine if she joined in? Like, you said she looked good, and you wouldn't mind if she joined in. Oh, well, I was just saying that to see what you was going to say because I believe you liked it anyway. And I said, honestly, I didn't even think about her in that way until you brought that up to me.
Oh.
So, mm-hmm. So I never looked at L like that, but when you planted that seed, and you got to be careful when you're dating someone in the seeds that you plant. When you planted that seed, that had me feeling myself, and I was like, oh, let me start flirting a little bit. You know what I'm saying? I'm not even going to lie. I started flirting a little bit and stuff. But and then I explained to her, and she made it seem like, oh, no, it can't work. So I made it clear. I said, listen, although Ella's on the phone talking about I never again with role model, I said she's lying. She's going to call me tomorrow. And she definitely did. Okay? And I said, B, are you sure this is what you want? I said, and B was like, oh, you know, I don't know. Well, she was like playing that hard to get kind of role. You know what I'm saying? And I was like, you're making it sound as though I cheated. I said, I can't cheat on you if I'm not in a relationship. And how much cheating could it have been if I've never even met her? Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like,
are you having this conversation?
It had me puzzled because I'm like, you acting like you're in your feelings. Number one, you never met me. I definitely ain't meet her and stuff like that. And you're getting upset with something you already know. You already knew right. I was talking. We were having conversations. You already knew she was attracted to me. So it just bothered me that she was getting upset with that. Okay. Sure enough, okay, the next day, B wanted to call me and wanted to work it out. L wanted to call privately. And L said, oh, now that we got rid of them, now we can be together. I pushed the brakes on L and I said, definitely not. We can't be together. Okay. And she was like, oh no, I really want to meet you. You're not talking to them no more. I really want to meet you. I'm buying a flight right now to come see you. And I was like, nah. Now during that time, when she said that, I started like more so talking to Q, which is Queen. I could say her name, guys. I started talking to Q, but not talking to her like that. I just thought Q was attractive, and I just was talking to her as friends. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would help Queen out in battles and stuff. Well, she was a shooter for me. She was shooting for me in verses and stuff like that. Before I even had much on her board, she had, like, 200-300K on my board or whatever the case may be. So, you know, Q was just dope, you know, good vibe and stuff. We barely even had phone conversations and stuff. But whenever we seen each other on stream, she would just sit and watch my streams and stuff. And I'll be shocked that she's like even still there. You know what I'm saying? This is before I was like that even popular on the app. Okay. Mm-hmm. So
at
now
this point, no, B is gone. H is gone. We're now have L.
No one's actually really gone. Okay. They was faking the funk because they were on the phone with each other. Okay. No one was gone.
Okay.
Where they going? So no one was actually really gone. They were in their feelings, but they weren't gone. They would hit me up privately, but they weren't gone. You know what I'm saying? The only person that kept it calm, cool, collective was H. But H was doing her own damn thing. So that's why H didn't really give a damn. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, me and H was cool. She stayed cool with me through the whole thing and stuff like that. And so now Q had a birthday coming up. Okay. Queen had a birthday coming up. Her birthday's August 30th, guys. So during her birthday, I was like, yo, what you doing for your birthday? She said, she was going to Miami. I said, you going to Miami? Who you going with? Your girlfriend, like an ex or something? Like, she's that, like, no, by was myself. That fishing?
Was that you fishing? You was fishing?
That a little something, a little something.
Okay, okay, you was fishing.
So when she told me that, I said, oh, my family live out there. I'm always out there. I said, I'll come out there with you. She said, for real? I'm like, yeah. So she was like, all right, you can pull up. So when she told me I could pull up, I said, you know, I'm dead ass. Like, I'm really going to come. So she's like, I got out there before her. I was out there 3 days before she even landed out there. Okay. You know, so when she got out there, of course, I brought her something for her birthday. I brought her like this Louis Vuitton weed tray. I brought her some weed, like an ounce or whatever. I brought her like a bottle of Moet and stuff. Like, I got her ready for her birthday. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Got her a card and stuff like that. And I told her we had a mansion, like I was doing a mansion party. It was my sister's boyfriend's birthday, and we all chipped in. We had this big Airbnb mansion party or whatever. So Queen was staying.
Quick question. You guys were just having casual conversation off.
Casual conversation. It wasn't about talking to each other. It wasn't about flirting. It wasn't about being together. Because once again, I never met Queen.
Okay,
and I can't be with nobody I ain't meet, guys. Remember what I said? We cannot be together if I ain't meet you. We can talk.
Right.
We can talk.
And why did Roll say she can't be get, because I can't be with somebody I haven't what? Not met, but she gotta know what they smell. All right. I just wanna make sure y'all stay paying attention. Y'all paying attention. Let's go. Okay. All right, go ahead. Continue.
Shut up, Travel. Trouble too. Not peanuts. Guys, just for the record, I smell like YSL, okay? YSL for life. All right. Just for the record. Okay. All right. So here we go. So now, you know, so Queen's like, all right, we gonna meet or whatever. So Queen wound up, you know, coming out there. I wound up picking up from the flight. Okay, I picked her up and I asked her where she was staying at.
How she smell?
He said, the Fountain Blue. Now, when I see Queen, you know, come on, look at this. Look at this beauty, guys. Ooh. Look at this. When I see Queen, I was like, yeah, she probably looked like this on camera. But when you see her, you know what I'm saying? Okay. Now, when I seen her, she had on this army. I know exactly what she had on, y'all. She had on this army fatigue outfit. And I was like, oh, shit. Like, she had the fatty on her and everything. I was like,
how she smell?
She smell hella good, y'all. She smell good. She smell good, y'all. She smell good. So I was like, oh, okay. So she got in the car and I was like, where you staying at? She said the Fountain Blue. Now here's why I was impressed. And guys, I talk about this all the time. I'm all about, you know, the models is all about self-empowerment, but it impressed me that she's single, okay, that she can actually still, being single and all, still take herself out for her birthday, okay? She spent a week out there for her birthday, and that by far, like, I was impressed by that, because a lot of times when people are single and stuff like that, they're afraid to spend money on themselves and treat themselves to something good and stuff like that, and I admired the fact that she did that. You know what I'm saying? I even told her that. I said, you know, that's dope that you know, you didn't buy and get no cheap hotel because it was just you. You got the Fountain Blue.
I love that.
I don't know if y'all know the Fountain Blue. That is expensive, y'all. All right. It's like Ritz-Carlton status. All right. So I was impressed by that. So I went upstairs to her hotel. Now her friend did. She did have a friend surprise her. Her friend surprised her and booked the room next door.
Oh, that's why I'm looking at
her friend. Came out here with her boyfriend. So it was her best friend that lived in New York came out there with her boyfriend, and they wind up surprising her and stuff like that. So I chilled in Queen's room. We sitting there, we smoking, and we drinking. Bye. We actually ordered food. Our first food that we ate together was tacos. I remember all of that, guys.
Oh, okay.
We ordered tacos and stuff like that. And then it was like 1 o'clock in the morning. I want to say like going on 2 maybe. And then she hits me with the, I'm tired. She was like, all right, so I'm going to see you later tomorrow.
She gave you the boot?
Now, I'm not saying I expected to stay there, guys, as she should. Whatever, y'all. Shoot, I was twisted. I can't drive home like that.
She said, so It's been lovely, but I need to get to bed. And I can't sleep with you in my room. Okay. Okay. She said, I can't sleep with you in my room. So
Yeah, she wasn't about that life. So that. She kindly and respectfully gave me the boot out of her room, y'all. So I went downstairs in my car. It was like 2 a.m, y'all. I looked and I said, hell no, I can't do this drive. Where they parked my car from the valet is exactly where the fuck I fell asleep at. I fell asleep till about 5 a.m, y'all. What? And at 5 a.m, I woke up and I drove myself home. I crashed the car before doing that. So I always promise myself, whenever I'm like that, I'm always going to sleep. And then, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, that's what I did.
Okay. Boom. Okay.
The next day was her actual birthday.
Okay.
Queen and I was supposed to chill. I heard nothing from Queen.
No text?
Yeah, in her face.
No text? She didn't
call me, no nothing. And I did call her, and she said, yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to go to the beach, and then I'll call you back. She ain't never called me back. So in my mind, I took it that, damn, did I do something? I was questioning, did I do something wrong? Because I was there. She kindly kicked me out. And didn't you not even call me? When you know I kind of came out here, like, you know, the vibe with you.
Now, that whole day you didn't hear from her, did you reach out and she didn't reply, or you just waited to see if she was
going? I reached out and she did reply hours later and stuff like that. But that was hours later. Okay. But you know how niggas are, okay? I know how people are. You don't call me next.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And it wasn't like I was trying to holler. We was just cool. You know what I'm saying? But
you were looking forward to spending time with her.
Looking forward to spending time with her. So, as a matter of fact, the room that I was supposed to get in that house, I wound up not getting because she didn't reach out. So I was like, oh, I don't need that room. Just give me this room. You know, I wanted, you know what I'm saying? So, long story short, you know, I wound up hitting up L.
So L kept pressing me. Hold on, just like that. Great night. You she doesn't let you stay, but you don't hear from her. In that instant, you decided to just go message.
Because L was already messaging me, and then L knew I was meeting up with
Queen. Yeah.
Okay. L knew that. She was like, oh, you going out there. And I was like, it ain't even like that. We don't flirt. At this point, Queen and I wasn't flirting or anything. We was just really like cool. Like, okay. I just thought she was dope. I wanted to get to know her. And then when I met up with her, I seen we had so much in common, but she didn't realize it yet that we had stuff in common. I realized it, but Queen didn't realize it. Okay. So, but anyway, I called L. And then Elle's like, oh, you could go out there for her, but you can't just come see me and stuff. So I said, you know what, Elle? I'm changing my flight. I'm not going back to New York. I'm coming to see you. So when I leave in the next 2 days or whatever it was, I said, I'm flying to Austin, Texas.
Oh, so you was doing a little tour. Okay.
Now, guys, this is, mind you, this is like after my life of like I had to give up my two stores. I own two T-Mobile stores that I had to give up, guys. So I wound up, you know, I had to give that up. I was free to do whatever I wanted to do. Okay. So that's what I decided to do. I was like, let me do a little traveling. So I booked a flight to go to Austin, Texas.
Okay. So did you see Queen before you left at all? Or that was how you parted ways? She never called you back, so you just left?
No, I was still out there partying and stuff and hanging out. So the very next day, this is after Queen's birthday now. Okay. This is the next day.
Okay.
Queen hits me up. So when she hits me up, I'm like, yo, you were supposed to hit me up for yesterday. You didn't even hit me up. Like, I'm like, well, she was like, yo, I'm sorry. I got caught up. She smoked so much weed. She fell asleep. Like, you know, she like went to the beach and fell asleep. And she was like, she really didn't wind up. She wound up really not doing much for her birthday anyway, you know, because of her friends and stuff like that and stuff. So she wound up saying, she was like, yo, I'll come over. So I said, you gonna come over? And she was like, yeah. And then, so she, you know, she checked out of her hotel. Her friends was leaving later on that night anyway. So they checked out of their hotel. They came, they pulled up to the mansion party and stuff like that. We was in the pool. We just having a good time. You know, I'm still not looking at her like that. We're just hanging out. She winds up, Queen, her friends winds up leaving. Queen winds up spending the night as a friend. Nothing happened and stuff. We was just cool, hanging out once again. The very next day, we woke up, and you know me, I'm a jet ski. I love jet skis, guys. Anytime I go on a vacation, we gotta do jet skis. Okay. So I'm like talking to my sisters. My sisters is there. She met like half my family. I asked my sister if she wanted to get on a jet ski. I rode my sister, one of my sisters on a jet ski. The other one was scared. I looked at Queen. I said, she probably going to say no. You know how some girls could look bougie and stuff, got the hair and stuff. So I said, Queen, you want to get on a jet ski with me? She said yes. When she said yes, that's when I was like, oh, okay. All right, let's go. So she gets on a jet ski. When we first pulled off, she had no life vest. I went back and got her a life vest. Thank God I did. Okay. So, so I'm riding her around. We riding back and forth. We making videos and stuff. I wind up stopping and cutting off the engine and just chilling. A boat goes by. So, you know, it makes it whenever a boat goes by, get a little wavy and stuff. Long story short, the jet ski is about to fall over. And I feel it tilting. I said, this girl is going to kill me if she falls in the water. So what I did to save her and to stop her from falling is I threw myself over in the water. I threw myself over in the water and I lift up the jet ski. I had to pick the jet ski back up. And then like she was good. Now here's where I started to realize I liked her. When I did that, when I jumped in the water, Queen then turned around on a jet ski. Now, for those of you who've never been on a jet ski, that was Queen's first time on a jet ski. When you're new and brand new on a jet ski, you are afraid to get up, maneuver, or do anything on it. I know I was, okay? So the fact that she was able to stand up, turn around, and she's like, here, take my hands. Now, mind you, I did not...
This sounds real...
Yeah. So she literally, like, put her hands down and try to pick me up out of the water. And I told her, nah, I got it. I want to be able to get on a jet ski by myself, right? So we then turned around and I did get on a jet ski by myself and stuff. But that moment of her holding her hand out and trying to save me and get me out of the water stuck with me. And that was the first time I realized I really like this girl. Oh my God, not the Titanic music.
Y'all can picture it.
She get on my nerves.
Bro. Don't let go, bro.
You might as well cut it off because this next part is not Titanic.
All right.
So now Queen, you know, I'm having such an amazing time with Queen, okay? And I could tell Queen's having an amazing time with me and stuff like that. Like, she's opening up more and stuff like that. So am I. And then, you know, of course, the next day we was leaving. And I was like, you know what? I'm having fun. But I said, I cannot lie. I don't want to start this friendship off with a lie. And I said, I'm not going to lie to you. You did not answer the phone when I was calling you on your birthday and stuff like that. And because of that, it caused me to make a move. And she was like, what do you mean? I was like, it was hard for me to tell her, but I was like, I changed my ticket from New York to fly out to Austin, Texas. So I could tell in Queen's face that she was like bothered by it, but we weren't together. So she was like, oh, okay. Like, it was almost like, oh, okay. So you made a decision because you didn't hear me to go out there. And I was like, yeah. Now, so Queen winds up, she was supposed to leave with me, but wound up leaving after me and stuff. She wound up, my mom wound up dropping her to a hotel. Like, my mom's went and dropped me to the airport, dropped her to a hotel because she wound up having to stay there a little longer. And then she wound up leaving out the next day. I believe my mom picked her up. And that was her first time meeting my mom. So her and I was just friends.
Okay.
And stuff. So, my mom did that. There was some things that she left in the car and stuff. So she wound up going back the next day. I wound up going to see Elle.
Okay.
Guys, now here's, y'all ready? When I went to go meet Elle, here's was the problem. I don't like cigarettes, guys. I do not like cigarettes.
One thing
I hate is freaking cigarettes. Guys, don't give me that Black and Mild crap. Oh, I smoke Black and Milds, not cigarettes. Because at the end of the day, the same smell. from that ashtray smell is, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not gonna lie, here was the first thing. When she came to pick me up, she had her daughter. Elle had her daughter in the car. Okay. And I was like, okay, hey, you know, how you doing? And Elle tried to reach over and tongue me down. And I went, whoa. Okay, number one.
Wait, how'd that go again?
Smell like cigarettes.
Wait, how'd that go again? When she tried to kiss you?
Whoa. You know, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, number one, the whole car reeked of cigarettes. Number two, her breath smelled like cigarettes because she, you know. And so, and then number three, when she tried to do it, it wasn't romantic because we was on in a Wendy's line in the bathroom. So I'm like, I'm not going to remember our first kiss being in Wendy's. Come on now.
Your first kiss was going to be in line waiting on 4 for 4.
No, I was waiting on a salad. I was eating healthy during that time.
Waiting on 4 for 4.
Is that
everybody put 4 in the comments. Everybody put 4 for 4 Okay. All right. Okay. So we're not starting off good because she smelled bad. Got it.
Okay. And then not that she smelled bad, and she just smelled like cigarettes.
Got it. Okay.
Okay. So, and I didn't like that. So I was waiting for a later time where she didn't, maybe, or something like that. But when I got there, we got to our house, I was already feeling sick because I was in a car smelling the cigarette. So my stomach was bothering me and stuff. But the only person I could think of was Queen.
Okay.
So all the moments we spent with her, I was just thinking about Queen because I'm like, dang, I just spent this time with this amazing person. That's and now I'm coming in cigarettes and stuff. So here's one of the things she said was she said she wanted to meet up with one of her friends that's from the app. So when she said that, I was like, I bet we could do that. I said, where she live at? She said, Dallas. In my mind, I said, Queen lives in Dallas. Okay, here goes the creep roll. Queen lives in Dallas.
So you smiled on the inside and didn't say nothing because the L who you just went to visit has said she wants to take a road trip. And the place that she is road tripping to just so happens to also be where Queen lives.
Yes. So Austin, Texas is like 3 to 4 hours away from Dallas. Okay, guys. So now when she says this, I'm like, I was like, all right, we could go. I'll pay for the hotel, everything. So she's like, all right. And I was like, what time are we leaving? We leaving now? And she was like, no, we can leave. I said, no, let's leave now.
You couldn't hold it together? You couldn't play?
I wanted to get out of the house. I ain't even going front. Okay. I didn't want to be there. It was like, you know, there was nothing in Austin to do. I was like, what the hell? Where am I? You know what I'm saying? So I was excited for us to just take the road trip. And now I remember Queen had gave me her Addy.
Okay.
Like, so she gave me an Addy, and I was like, well, not the address, but she gave me, like, told me that area or whatever. So I said, all right, let me book this little spot right here and stuff like that. And when Queen actually gave me the address, I said, oh, I'm about a mile away from you.
You booked a hotel a mile away from her place, not knowing.
It happened to be a mile away. Okay.
This is either like coincidence or you real creepier.
Oh, it gets real creepier. It gets creepier. Okay. It's a mile away, guys. I'm telling you, I looked on the Navi. It said a mile away. Check this out. So now I'm talking. I'm in a hotel talking to L and stuff. And I was like, I'm not going front. I kind of lied to L. I said, I'll be back. I'm going to go get some food, something.
Not that roll be back.
Said I'll be back. I drove that mile. Okay. I went to her. I went to Queen. Now, Queen, I should have knew she was a feisty motherfucker because I spent some time like driving in circles and she told me where to park at. I parked at the wrong spot. She was like, you know what? I'm taking my ass back upstairs. Cause
she was gonna leave you because you was taking too long.
She was gonna leave me because I was taking too long. And I said, the nerve, you know, so I wound up finding her finally, you know, so I went, you know, we we hung out for a little bit and stuff like that. And I was like, yo, you know, I was like, yo, we talking. I was like, she was like, oh, where you staying at? I said, oh, I'm staying at the such and such. And she's like, you are? And I was like, yeah. And she's like, oh, you right across the street. I said, what do you mean across the street? She opens up her blinds and I'm looking at the hotel I'm staying at.
What?
Across the hallway.
Wait a minute.
I can see the window of the room that I'm staying in.
Wait. So you drove.
Look at that.
So you did not know her exact address until you got there.
I didn't know her exact address until I got
the
there.
The hotel that you picked is literally.
Literally across. The reason why I said 1 mile away is because it has this big highway.
So you have,
and to go around the highway to get
there. Okay, so let me get this right. You are spending time with Queen right now. When you were there, because you were road tripping from visiting Elle. So Elle is at the hotel across the street.
Elle is at the hotel with the friend.
And you're
and now I'm with
you're
Queen.
Looking back at Elle. Oh, okay, all right.
But once again, Queen and I are not together.
Got it.
So okay. It's not like I'm doing anything or I'm like, you know, but I did start to realize I did like and have feelings for the Queen. You know what I'm saying? And I still ain't, like, I knew it because obviously I was a fiend to go see her again, right? Right after we just left Miami, I was kind of fiend out to go see her again. So that was one. But and then two was, like, when I got back to the room, I start realizing how Elle and I are just not compatible at all. Like, Elle gets mad at the most dumbest crap. Like, if I go into someone's stream, she wants to get an attitude. And I don't like that. You know what I'm saying? Don't tell me I can't go in someone's room and gift or do whatever. You know what I'm saying? So that kind of bothered me and stuff. We wound up, I wound up going to see Queen again. You know, we went, ate together. And then I went back to the room, ate with her. You know what I'm saying? I was being a little sneaky. I'm not going to lie. Because Elle did not know I was doing that. Okay? As a matter of fact, Elle tried to call my bluff. Because one time I said, hey, I need you to take me to my cousin's. And then Elle said, well, I'm going to drive you there. And I said, And I was like, well, it's the bar. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to.
It's so bad.
So she let me out. She let me out and dropped me there and stuff like that. And I called her and I told her to come pick me back up. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. So how does this Dallas trip conclude? Do you head back to Austin with Elle?
I did head back to Austin with Elle.
Okay.
Okay, now when I head back to Austin with Elle, there was like little certain things that she would say or she would do. She would just have little attitudes and stuff like that. And it was like kind of like bothering me. And I was like, in my mind, I already wrote that this ain't going to work. So I kind of wrote her off already and stuff like that. So when she took me back, I literally while I was there, I was like a little sad. I was a little depressed because I was like, here I am. My flight don't leave until 3 days later, because I plan on spending like 3 days over there. Okay. And then I was like, oh no, I don't know how I'm gonna make it. I might have to book my flight to go back. But on the sideline, Queen and I are texting. And I was like, dang, I had so much fun seeing you. Queen's like, she's feeling the same way. And she was like, oh, I missed you already. And I was like, dang, I missed you already too. And I was like, you know what? I said, I'm about to call an Uber. She said, go ahead. So when Queen told me to call a fucking Uber, I said, oh, then I looked up the Uber. That shit was like $400. I said, yeah, oh, nah, we ain't going to do no Uber.
That's expensive.
So Queen went and checked the Greyhound.
You got on a bus.
So she looked up a Greyhound, and I took a bus that same night. I must have got there around 5. I left at 9.
How you explain to Elle to drop you at the Greyhound?
Oh, I just told her, yo, drop me at the Greyhound.
Oh, okay.
I wasn't lying. I didn't have to tell her who I was going to see. We're not in no relationship. I don't owe you that. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
But at the same time, we weren't getting along while I was there.
Got it. Okay.
But it could very well have been because Queen was on my mind heavy. You know what I'm saying? Once you see that, it's kind of like it changed my whole mental, like, you know? So I got on the Greyhound. I left at 9. I got there around 12. Queen met me and picked me up from where I was at, and I went and stayed at Queen's house. So I spent those 3 days with Queen, and once again, we were just friends. But I wound up hanging out with her and chilling, just smoking, and like, you know, just it was just having fun. You know what I'm saying? And then Queen, you know, Queen wound up telling me she was digging me. I wound up telling Queen I was digging her. But during that time, Queen was also talking to someone else.
Oh, okay. We got that.
Okay. You might want to bring Queen in now.
So let's pause this right here, okay? Let's pause this. I feel like, I think D'Angelo, I think some people have faded off, which is totally fine, but we will have a little chat. So if y'all are still hanging with us, this is Dating Unfiltered. We got about another 15, 20 minutes left, guys. Thank you if you've been hanging this whole time. I really, truly appreciate it. We are getting a role model and Queen story, and I'm gonna give you a short recap. Role model started off with this streaming in 2020, and she got herself into an on-app stream poly situation. We had B and H who came onto the scene and were cutting up in the stream, and by that meaning gifting like crazy. And when they got into it together, B said, you know, well, we can, you know, be in this poly. And Roll says, yeah, sure, why not? Thinking it was a joke, but B was serious. Roll reached out to H, and H said, sure, why not? And they developed this little online poly situationship, okay? So she has this going on, splitting her time between streaming and managing two women's expectations while they're here, okay? And now, you know, there's a little insecurity and things going on there, but she's managing it, and she's confiding in her streamer friend, L. Okay, letting L know, you know, this is going on. B, in the poly, kind of has a sense in something going on and starts poking the bear about, you know, do you like L? Like, what's going on? It would be cool if you wanted to talk to L. Now, Rose said, you know, she wasn't even thinking about it that way, but the seed was planted, so she starts talking to L a little more. L starts feeling her, and this feeling starts to develop there. They come to an understanding about, you know what, we're talking, but we're agreeing not to give our phone numbers out, okay? It's just us and my poly situation on the side, all right? So this is happening. One day they're streaming, and L has someone named M that pops into her stream and goes crazy on her. Roll starts to recognize that every time L streams, M is in there. M is in there, L is in there, and the pattern starts to change. One day, M ends up in Roll's stream late night, randomly, just says, hey, you know, I put on your top, you know, here, I'm gonna gift you a little bit, but you know, you're really cool. And so there happens to be, you know, there's people on here that give readings. There happens to be someone that Roll knows that was in the box kind of giving her a reading and recognize some energy between Roll and M. You guys are connected somehow. And they start talking about it. M starts expressing how she's into a streamer. Roll's like, let me know who it is. I'ma hook you up. M reveals that said streamer is L. And Roll says, oh, hell no. Nah. Like, we had this agreement. You're not supposed to have our phone numbers. Clearly, she gave out the phone number. This is not cool. She confronts L. L says, loophole. I ain't give her my phone number. I gave her my text number. That's not even my real phone number. Like, that's not the same thing. Rose said, it is the same thing. I'm not cool with that, but whatever. Do you, boo. I'm over it. I'm done. L is upset by that, and you know, hell hath no fury like a woman scorned. So L takes it upon herself that if I'm going down, I'm taking the whole ship down. So Rose is at work. Rose gets a WhatsApp phone call. It's her poly calling, and she notices it's just the poly. Oh, yeah, it's the two ladies that, you know, my two poly, B and H, is calling me. Boom, picks up the phone. Instead of two faces being on this video call, there's three, y'all. There's a B, there's H, and L. They are all on the video call to confront this situation that's happening. They all say, I'm done with you. I'm over. It's fine. Roll's like, we can't even be upset about something because we're not all even in a real relationship because we haven't even met yet. Everybody says they walking out, but they don't really go anywhere. And L says, well, since they've decided to leave, I'm still here. Roll says, I'ma just put that on ice. At this time, around this time in the back end, Roll was interacting with Queen, with Q. Just light conversation. She'd be in each other's stream. We know stream, you know, stream friendship developing. So they start talking. Queen mentions that she's going to Miami for her birthday. Roll says, bet, I'ma pull up. Queen says, bet. Roll says, no, I'm for real. Like, I have family out there. I'm going to pull up. She says, okay. Roll goes out a couple of days early, sees some family. Queen comes down, picks her up from the airport, loves what she sees. And even better yet, she smells amazing, right? Because Roll can't date anybody until you've met them and know how they smell. She says she smells great. The next couple of days, that first day, they spent together, they each take her to the hotel, is impressed that she's taking herself out and she's staying at the Fountain Blue and she's just on her own. She's just impressed, you know, like she's taking care of herself, treating herself and doing these things. go, they spend the whole day together, order food, smoke, all of this thing in the room. 1, 2 o'clock in the morning hits. Queen says, so it's time for me to go to sleep. And I can't sleep with you in here. And Roll's like, respectfully, good night. Roll is a little twisted and faded, gets to her car, says, I'm gonna be responsible. Roll sleeps in her car. First night meeting, Roll sleeps in the car, wakes up at about 5 a.m., drives herself home, looking forward to spending time again, because per their last interaction, hey, we're gonna go to the beach, we're gonna do this. She reaches out, waiting to hear from Queen. Didn't hear from Queen, y'all. All day, nothing. Didn't hear from her. In this period of time of not hearing from her, Roll got in her feelings. And Roll said, well, you know what? That's fine. I'm here for somebody else. In this time period, y'all, she has picked up the phone and contacted L. Okay? Contacted L, said, you know what? I'm gonna come see you in Austin. I'm gonna change my ticket. I'm gonna come out to Texas. Hears from Queen later, next day, finds out Queen smoked a little too much, got a little exhausted from being in the sun, and just fell asleep on her birthday. She missed out on her own birthday too. Rose said, well, you know what? New day, I'm checking out. Why don't you just come over to the mansion? She comes over and they have an amazing time together. They have an amazing time together, getting to know each other. They have a jet ski moment, y'all. Roll throws herself off the jet ski to save Queen from falling, picture Titanic, all of this, all of that, you know, Roll's in the water, you know, Queen turn around and get her out. I mean, it's just a jet ski magic moment, okay? They have this great moment connecting. Roll is like, man, I'm really liking her, but I gotta leave the next day. I'm gonna be honest. So she lets Queen know, I'm leaving, I'm not gonna lie. I changed my ticket, I'm gonna go see Elle. Is what it is, okay? Okay, Queen says, all right. Goes to see Elle, gets to Austin, Texas. The smell is not that great. It's not that she doesn't smell good. Smells, what is she, what was the smell, y'all? Find the emoji of what the overpowering smell was, because the emoji is in there. There it is, y'all. The smell of cigarettes just wasn't doing it for her. But she got there and all she could think about was Queen. Elle says while she's there, hey, do you mind if we go see one of my friends and take a road trip? Roll's like, yeah, sure, why not? Where is this road trip to? Dallas, Texas. Guess who's in Dallas, Texas, y'all? Queen is in Dallas, Texas. Roll then perks up and says, yes, we can go right now. In fact, let's go right now. I will pay for everything. Pay for the hotel. I got it. Go up to Dallas. She books a hotel. Hotel literally turns out to be directly across the highway from Queen's place. As in, open the curtain, look out, you are looking at Queen's place. The few days that she is there, she leaves on her, I'll be right back. And every time she was be right back, she was be with Queen and then come right back. They end up leaving after a few days, go back down to Austin. Roll is still thinking about Queen. She has 3 more days left. Figures, this is not vibing right now. Me and Elle, it's not it. I need to get back. Calls an Uber, too expensive. Talks to Queen. Queen finds a Greyhound. Roll gets on the bus back to Dallas that night to spend with Queen. Y'all with me on this? And now you know, we cannot just hear this side of the story. We're gonna get the tail end of this because she's here, y'all. She's been listening to this tale the whole time. We've been seeing snippets of her face here.
Hello,
so Queen. Chase, you coming up? So what was it? Okay, so from what we hear from the story, it was all a friendship in Miami, and it turned was clearly after Miami, and when Roll got to Texas, she couldn't stop thinking about you. So that was a turning point. The jet ski, these moments was a turning point for you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Was that the same turning point for you? Of maybe this could be more or?
That was not the turning point for me. Okay. Prior to getting to take the time to even get to know her a little bit better, I was coming out of like a marriage divorce sort of thing. So a relationship was not in my sights at all. Okay. I wasn't even really considering. Like when I got on the app, I was tiptoeing into seeing what was going on out there, but I was not thinking, you know, any of that. So, so no. Okay. Y'all are so good about not looking at these comments. I'm not good.
Turn them off. Just click it. Turn it off. You just have to click it. You just have to turn them off. So you have this in Miami. You know, listen, if, I don't know if you were watching the comments and told the story about you respectfully saying, okay, you can't sleep here. Everyone said, ooh, and it was like, yeah, okay. So what was it for you then? Because you left Miami, so you stayed. So if that wasn't the turning point for you, when you found out that she was changed her flight and was going to CL, did that turn you off a bit?
Well, yeah. I mean, that was kind of a weird move to make. Now, I could understand, even though I wasn't cool with it. It wasn't really my call to make, but it was kind of strange that you would meet me and then go meet somebody else. But then on the other side, I could understand, like, if you didn't hear nothing else and that was it, and you had been working on something else too, then I mean, it makes perfect sense. I did not like it, but you know, I was like, well, okay, if that's what that was, you wanted to see somebody, then fine. But like she said, it wasn't anything serious. Right. I was still trying to get to know her. She was trying to get to know me a little bit, and we had all kinds of things going on outside of just each other. So no, it wasn't.
So you go back to Dallas and you find out that she's road tripping up.
I was basically saying the same thing you were. I was like, oh, you just hitting every city, every town. You got somebody there you're trying to meet up with. I see what you're doing. So that was another reason why I was not nowhere near taking her ass serious.
Okay.
So I'm like, every area code. All right.
So she gets to Dallas.
Uh-huh.
She messages you and says, hey, I'm here. I'm coming over. And what was the turning point then?
Because it took, you know, it was so much later. It was after so much time had been spent because of my previous relationships. I wasn't interested in anything more. So yeah. Even though I was being pursued, even at other angles, nobody was getting no play. It just wasn't happening because I wasn't available. You know what I mean? But once she got interested, she made sure that she let me know and the pursuit was on. And I mean, you know, I want to say this all happened in probably August. I want to say by October, I think I was kind of locked in and I knew that this was something that was going to be a little greater. Yeah.
So August, so September, October. So
It was September. Her birthday was the 30th.
Okay.
So it was September,
but so she wasn't locked in until October. Like she's a month.
For me, when you know, you said when you had your moment thank you. When you had your moment, you know, when it clicked on for you, that's when it happened for me, because I really, you know, I gave her more than I would just a friend, and I was recognizing that. Mm-hmm. But I wasn't fully open. It took me a while to open up, and it was
okay. So there's two layers here, right? So meeting on the app.
Mm-hmm.
And then becoming like a long distance relationship for a while, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like I know people don't necessarily, you know, jump into, maybe nowadays people kind of jump into, but that's something really you jump into lightly, right?
So I had no desire to do long distance relationship. I let it be known up front immediately. There's no way in hell I'm gonna have a serious relationship with you and you on the other side of Americas and okay. We can't talk and touch and feel. And ain't no way, it's not going to happen. And then she, you know how smooth roll is. She was like, I fly see you every weekend. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, oh, you will.
So
with her making that very clear role, mm-hmm. I think that's amazing, right? I think that's very important in relationships, right, everybody? That you make your intentions and your requirements or your boundaries known up front that, you know, I'm willing to pursue this. But it can't be like, if we're going to do something long term, it can't be like this forever. So know that if we continue with this, end goal has to be minimizing this distance or getting rid of this distance. Okay, so when she told you that role, you didn't flinch at that.
Oh, no, of course not.
Okay.
Of course not. I was literally flying every week to go see her. And then it turned out to every other week, because if I'm not coming out there, she was coming out. So I go out there 1 week, she come out there the next week. And we were seeing each other every week after that. And then in October, I want to say like towards Halloween, her family took a trip and we went and took the trip. I took the trip with her family. We went to OKC, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
So we what went was, to OKC. Yeah. We had a place out there, and we went out there, and I didn't leave. I never even went back home. Myself and my daughter went out there, and we stayed there until January.
And there was no service, so nobody was on their phones. It was like everybody was spending quality time together. Everyone was getting to know each other. We were just like playing games and we really got like focused time together that I don't even think people out here get anymore, you know, unless they go away.
Right. You kind of disconnect. So how did the discussion, I mean, it sounds like it was an easy discussion then to get into how are we going to get rid of this distance?
That took a while. That was, that was the following year.
Uh-huh. So you made this work so this is a year's time.
Yeah.
Queen's
so remember, I just moved out here October. This October that just passed. Mm-hmm. So a few months ago. So that even that part was hard, because it's like at first I didn't know she was serious. Let's bring it back a little bit. She was talking to someone in the beginning when we started too.
That doesn't make you sound any better. You know, it doesn't make the little college situation sound any better.
All I'm trying to say is that's what made it like a little harder for me to like, you know what I'm saying? To like, you know, but and then it's like when that was over, when I knew for a fact that was over and stuff, when we started taking each other more serious, that's when, and she had mentioned something about moving in together. And to me, a lot of times when people mention stuff, like even till today, when people mention marriage and stuff like that, I always freeze up and stuff, because I don't want to like, you know, think about that and then it doesn't happen. So, you know, when she brought it up to me, I thought she was joking at first. And then she brought it up again and I was like, oh, she's serious. And I had to ask her, you know, I had to let her know, because I come with baggage. You know, my baggage is, of course, my two dogs. Well, used to have two dogs, guys. Just lost my dog, RIP Egypt, and my daughter, you know, so, you know, and that's a lot to handle with my daughter and stuff like that. So I wanted to make sure that was something that she knew that I came with, and if she was able to handle that.
Okay. So a year of this time, like, in the comments, how many of you could make a long distance relationship or believe in long distance? You yes to long distance relationship, no to long distance.
It didn't feel like a year, but it was, huh?
Yes. Okay. Wow. So someone said temporarily. Okay, you prefer to. So how many? How long? So you guys did this for a year, and then when? So Queen mentions this, right? Like, listen, are you gonna move in? Now at this up to this point, right, Queen? You are very aware that she has her dog and.
Yes. Now, this I think we are going to have to disagree on, because moving in together was definitely not the top of my list. However, having a long distance relationship wasn't the top either. So the fair medium would be to figure out who's moving where. And I made it, not only did I make it clear that I wasn't doing long distance, I said there's no way in hell I'm moving to New York. So that it really only leaves one option.
Exactly.
I mean, we could have chosen another city to both move to.
That's true. Okay. But yeah, that wasn't gonna happen. And I knew that from the beginning. So instead of continuing to, you know, once we decided to be serious, I mean, there had been a point where she had spent 3 months with me in a row, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So that means, you know, so we had already gotten a feel for what it was going to be like to live together. You know, so by the time it came to actually decide, okay, this is time to, take the step to do something together and have something together, it wasn't so brand new. Even though it was different and it was quite the transition, it wasn't as brand new. Yes, Texas is definitely the place to be. But yeah,
in the middle. Okay, so you guys start talking about and you make the step. I know we all got to be very much so a part of it as Roel was packing and moving and doing all of that. So how did you obviously transition stuff aside? You're happy to have done it and moved? How are, like, this is, you know, a great example of, you know, meeting on the app, being able to find a love, even if you took the very scenic route to get to it on the app. You guys are, I would say, a like POF success story, right? One of our success stories of people meeting on and making it work. So what would you like tell other couples or maybe people that are in here that are kind of in this situation about how to make this work or how to make a long distance relationship work?
All right. So here's the thing, how to make it work. It's hard. It takes a lot of understanding to make it work and stuff like that, because we're still figuring it out. You know, us together as a team, you know, Queen don't like me on here. And, you know, long hours and stuff.
I don't like you on there long. Come on, tell the whole story. Don't do the bad.
I'm telling the whole story. Let me talk. Queen don't like me on here for long hours. So it takes you to, you when you're in a relationship, you do gotta set, like, you gotta have your priorities in line, you know, and you gotta make time for the people you love and stuff. So I then had to, you know, take a day off and stuff like that, which is, you know, to accommodate, you know, to make sure, like, we're both happy in this and stuff like that. So we're both, like, you know, top bad streamers and stuff like that. And it gets easier, you know, as you go along, but it's really hard to do. And one of the things that made it so much easier and stuff, and I'm gonna tell you the pros and the cons. Here's the pros. The pros is everybody knows Queen is my baby and stuff like that. That is the pros, okay? And I like the fact that the people who gift me now are genuinely gifting me, okay? Here's the cons. The cons is when you have to tell your audience that you are in a relationship, you're gonna lose out on 50% of your audience.
Okay.
You gotta be willing to make a sacrifice for your relationship, okay? And what I mean by that is I lost a lot of my gifters that wanted to be with me, you know, who thought that, oh, okay, gifting me was gonna get them somewhere. So one of the things I'm happy about is that I can actually come on here and be myself, not have to hide my relationship, and people still show me love versus me having to hide my relationship, because a lot of you guys are on here in relationships, but you're denying the relationship because y'all want to keep certain gifters. If those gifters are really like real supporters of y'all, they're gonna support you no matter what. But you gotta find build the courage to let them know, hey, this is what it is. This is what it is. And that's one of the things I'm most proud of, is that I don't have to hide my relationship with Queen, and she don't have to hide hers. You know what I'm saying? We can both be open and honest to our audience and let them know, okay, I'm in a relationship, but we can still have friends on air and stuff like that. And she don't, you know, she don't get jealous at that.
Queen.
Yes, yeah, so one of the things that you mentioned that I wanted to make sure that I said something about, because I know that other people can relate when I tell the story in my stream, is that as far as like how we got here or how we even did that first year long distance, I am so super, super old school, right? So I'm like FaceTiming on the iPhone and you looking at me and I'm looking at you. I'm like, what? I don't know if I'm comfortable with that. But she definitely broke me out of that. This one will want to FaceTime from the moment you wake up all day long. You know, she was just really comfortable not only with herself being on FaceTime, but with her expressing her want to see me on FaceTime all the time. And I'm like, but you know what I'm like, but she just didn't care. So I think this day and age with this whole FaceTime and being able to be live and being able to communicate all the time and the openness that she had with me made me want to be more open, made me want to trust the interaction that we were having. So I think that taking advantage of all these, you know, video calls, I think the app even has video calls where you can talk to someone that you've been talking to on the app. Taking advantage of that, I think, is what helped break me down, because I'm like, no, you need to come here and take me on a date. But now it's like, oh, well, you know, you are kind of here and we are kind of on a date, you know, even though we'll go on other dates later, it doesn't feel so disconnected. Like in my mind, long distance relationships can be.
Right. But finding and being creative in finding those ways to connect when you can't be together because you have all this technology and things to do. Because I know there'll be things like that. You know, I've seen in the stream, and let's be clear, everybody who's in here, right? Like a long distance relationship in general is challenging. And this adds a whole other layer when you add this streaming and live streaming to that as well, right? So there's two things being you know, challenging here, right? In a situation and finding a way to make it work. That's a whole other show for a whole other discussion about dating and being in the same house. That is a whole other, we're not gonna go down that rabbit hole. But I think that you really nailed it when you said being creative and finding ways to limit the distance, right? Until we can be together.
Ms. Ball, like, she's a lesbian. So no, she wasn't dating a guy, Ms. Balls.
Oh, you know,
let that fly.
You know,
but finding ways to do that. And I know for a fact that, you know, you would do things like, you know, like let's order food and just sit down and let's just do that on a FaceTime or a video call. Let's eat together or watch Netflix or do things like that. So would you guys, so based on your experience and what you're going through, so you would recommend that you can find love and happiness on Plenty of Fish?
Oh, definitely. I definitely think you can.
It's possible.
It's hard. Another thing that makes it hard is, like, you know, especially when you're trying to find it. I always said even when I was younger that I would rather have someone where when I'm broke, I would rather have someone that I love when I'm broke and have nothing than to find them when I'm already, you know, role model fresh, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that's something I always told myself, and that's one of the things that I adore about our relationship, is that I wasn't as successful as I am right now when her and I hit it off, you know what I'm saying? So and it just makes it even better.
Yeah.
You know, because it's like you don't have the thought on your mind that, oh, maybe they're using you for what you have and stuff like that. And that's one of the things of trying to find love on this app, especially during the live portion of it, is like you can sometimes come across people like that. You know what I'm saying? But one of the things that I did was, you know, there's a time period, like I said, where I didn't gift her. You know, there's times where it's like I don't go in her room and gift her. You know what I'm saying? And it's the love didn't change.
I love it. Thank you guys for sharing that. And just to be clear, if anybody hasn't followed the story, okay, this love story that manifested and managed through has now ended up, they do live together now. Yeah. They have a home together. They, you know, if you frequent their streams, especially in the morning, Roll gets her cream. Do you still get cream? Have you done that lately? I think that's really funny. It's always great when she gets it and she's excited to take a sip and then it's like, wah!
She takes her time and looks in the glass now.
Yeah, she does. She learned. But guys, please, if you haven't already, please hit the two of them with a fave. Please go show them love and support. They have amazing content together, and it's always going on. I appreciate you guys sharing your story. Guys, so if you are in here and you are dating and looking for love, listen, it can happen. You too, you know, you might be visiting somebody.
I do have a question for Queen. I heard someone ask it in the comments. So they said, well, Queen, when did you know Roll was the one? What made you drop your guard and say yes to Roll? That was the question.
She already answered that. She said you Steve Urkeled her. You just wore her down.
You just kept showing up.
Walking in.
That's not true. I mean, I did open my balcony and see the hotel. I mean, that was a little surprising. I still think about that a little bit, but I mean, no. I wanted to say that it became more clear as the time went by. Like when someone says, I got used to being told a lot of things. I'm going to give you this. I'm going to do this. she didn't just talk about, I had to see those things, and she did those things. She said, I'm going to do this, and she was there. She said, I'm going to be this, and she was that. So it took a lot of me seeing that, and it didn't take a whole lot of time either, which I can appreciate at this point in my life. But yeah, I started to see it, and I know by October for sure, especially when we went away with my family, because, you know, you don't just have anybody go away with your family. But I knew by then for sure that it was going to be something.
Mary, did you have with the backpack?
What's the backpack? I don't understand it either.
What's with the backpack?
She put the backpack in there. I picked up a red backpack. I just so happened.
Lord.
And then they just went crazy with it.
Someone said, "Who said I love you first?" It's like the TikTok thing. Just point.
I wanna say we both did.
Ain't no both did first.
Wow.
Yes, you are incorrect. The ball.
Oh my God.
Okay.
We didn't both say it at the same time?
I'm pretty sure we didn't.
I'm pretty sure she said it first.
I'm pretty sure it took me a few weeks after. I know I gave you a few thank yous at first. Stop lying.
You know what?
Yeah.
You know what?
Now you remember.
Okay, she's right. I did tell her I love her. And she was like, oh, thank you.
She hit you with the Ariana minus the next.
Yeah,
thank you.
I just needed to know for sure. You know, I needed to know that I felt it. I wasn't just going to say it because she said it. I needed to know that that's how I felt too.
Okay,
and it didn't take long after.
Okay, someone else asked, Ro, do you miss New York?
Not really. I miss my family. That's it.
Okay. Not the place. Any other questions in the comments? Mary, did you have a question? Sorry, I only saw your comment. Is it anything? Jay said it first. One wish. All right. If you guys don't have any other questions, how long have y'all been together then now? Are we at?
Is it a question, Queen?
Oh, you're asking me? You know. What's this month? March?
1 year, 5 months. This is a shame.
It's one year and going on five months.
Well, they are.
1 year, 5 months.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Look at you.
What's the most romantic thing y'all have ever done together?
The most? Oh, my God.
Most romantic? Everything we do is romantic.
And I know that you took for the birthday. You did Miami again, right? For her birthday?
We did do Miami again.
Do Miami again. What do you mean?
We did.
Only did it one time. How did we do it again?
Well, we did
it last year for my birthday. Yeah, but my birthday's coming up now.
We're not talking about your birthday, boo.
Hers.
You met
her on her birthday, and then you guys did her Brand's birthday. You did Miami again, but you did it together for her birthday.
She didn't leave you unread
for her birthday this time.
Oh, nah.
On you for her birthday this time. You got to enjoy it together. Any other questions, guys? I think that's everything. Somebody had asked, y'all talked about marriage?
She don't got a short story. She ain't got a short story in her.
Do we plan on adopting? Not sure yet.
Ooh, look at all these. Oh. Wow.
Yes. Are they in the same house now?
Yes, we are in the same house right now as we speak.
Y'all, I'm in my room.
She has her own. She has her own streaming room. I have my own streaming room. And then when we leave our streaming room, we go into our bedroom.
Can you listen to Tribal? Like, can there be some lines? Can we have the boundaries?
Listen, y'all. If y'all have any more questions, they are both live now. You can pop over and ask them directly. Thank y'all so much for being on.
Yes, Queen does send me notes. She'd be like, all right, at this time, we meeting up. We have a date, a shower date.
Queen says we done. Y'all please hit them with the fave. Thank y'all so much for being on. I appreciate y'all so much. Y'all make sure you come here and show them some love.
Thank you.
Thank you, Roll. Let me close out here. Man, y'all was getting into business. Okay, y'all. Thank y'all for sticking this long. You know, it was only supposed to be 2 hours. I should have known better. When I roll on, I was going to be here for a minute. But I appreciate y'all rocking with me. This was amazing. Thank you guys so much. Again, this was a one-time event. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you are new and you would like more stories like this, we don't get as in-depth as we did this time, but every Tuesday, guys, every Tuesday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Entanglements in my stream. If you weren't aware, please make sure you come and join me there. We will have an all-new Entanglements this coming Tuesday. Just FYI, guys, this Tuesday, we're going to do our first ever completely anonymous entanglement. Anonymous. I'm talking lurker account, black screen, voice changer. So make sure y'all are here on Tuesday to find out, what's going on with this entanglement. I think they're doing that because it's going to be a good one and it may have to do with the app. So in any case, guys, once again, thank you so much for being here. Everyone who stayed the whole time, thank you so much. We did amazing. Look at y'all. Y'all are incredible. 6,000 views up here. If you haven't already, please make sure you hit the star by my name. Hit me with a fave. Y'all, we finally got a Jeep bonus thanks to Style and Grace. We saw a golden dragon. What a night. Amazing. And thanks to all of you guys for being here. Thank you so much. Thank you, Cajun, for being here. Thank you to Miss Chocolate. Thank you to D'Angelo. Thank you to Cajun for hopping in the middle for our discussion point. We didn't have another one, but it was fine because it was a great story. So I think that's it, guys. If you haven't already, please make sure you favorite the top three of this stream. Please hit Raider Rob with a fave, hit Style and Grace with a fave, and hit Dr. Weddington with a fave, please. Make sure y'all fave each other. I hope y'all been faving each other while you were in here. If you are brand new to the stream, please hit me with a fave and you can catch me on a regular stream and I can answer any of your questions. But thank you guys again. I can't say it enough. I hope the app had a good time. They will let me know afterwards. But thanks again, guys. We did it. We did it, Joe. Y'all, please also make sure you hit Travel Bay in the comments with a fave. Travel Bay has been keeping the comments going. Love her in the red. Thank you guys for being here. Don, Angie, who's in here? Roll call. Ed, what was your questions? I'm sorry, love. Okay, I won't block your. Wow. Smiley, Trista, Razine, GQ, Troll. I see you guys. Weddington, who was in here? Candy, mom number two and mom number one was in here. Italian, I see you. Rainin, emoji Mike. Classy Curves, I saw you here the whole time. Emoji JDFW, thank you guys so much. Inspired, I see you. Jazz, thank you guys. Mr. Redhead, thank you guys so much. Rico, I saw you here the whole time too. Jaeger, all right, guys, I'm gonna go to bed. We will be back on stream tomorrow. Thank you guys so much again. I don't even, you know what, this is what I'm gonna play. This is what we did, just because this made me laugh, y'all. This made me laugh when she said that, when she said, I definitely hit you with a couple of thank yous before I said it. I just thought of this and I just. Diamonds of a shine, but it wasn't a match. But sometimes about Vicky. Sometimes you tell them thank you. She said thank you, not next. She just said thank you. But I do thank you all. One taught me patience. Rella, I see you in there too. Y'all like my fish? It says live on it, but it's so bright. I gotta find a different spot. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right, y'all, we're gonna end the stream the same way we end every other stream, guys. Remember, every person, place, or encounter you come across, please always try to leave it better than it was before you got there. And if you can't do that, just don't make it any worse. Thank you, Razine. Just don't make it any worse. Chrissy, y'all have a good night. I will see you guys tomorrow. I will be up in the morning. We will be on tomorrow, and we got to do the Wordle. tomorrow. All right. Bye, guys.